Did you know that good sleep does more than just give you physical energy? Research shows that it helps with memory, emotional regulation, your immune system, and it helps you and your kiddos to think more clearly and make better decisions. Hey there, I'm Dr. Dave, and on today's Thrive in 5, I'll be sharing some bedtime tips for kids 2 through 6. All right, today's topic is something most of us are a big fan of. It's sleep. It may seem sometimes, though, that your kiddos don't love it all that much. From the day your child is born, sleep is a roller coaster. Newborn babies rarely sleep through the night, and even when they can sleep longer, within a few months, they need your help to learn to sleep through the night. But if you're watching this and you're a parent of a child older than that, you know that the challenge doesn't end there, right? Bedtime can be a struggle for both parents and kids. It's probably easy to think sometimes that it's pure stubbornness that keeps your child from wanting to go to sleep. But there could be a lot of reasons they're resisting bedtime. And as you better understand their perspective and needs, you can help everyone start to get enough sleep. So here are some things to think about. First, calming down and falling asleep are things kiddos need to learn. They can't just happen on their own. Luckily, there are ways you as parents can help. For starters, try to remember that getting angry at your child or threatening them when they won't go to bed only makes things worse. It makes it harder for them to relax and go to sleep. So maybe take some deep breaths and try to look at the situation from their point of view. Kiddos might hate missing out on all the things that are happening when they go to bed and want to spend more time with you. They might be scared to be by themselves in a dark room, or they might just have a hard time settling down. So they might make excuses to stay awake. So what can you do to help? Well, try these 3 tips. Number 1, pay attention to how much sleep your child needs. Some kiddos need more or less sleep than others to function well. If you plan their sleep routine around their specific needs, bedtime may become less of a struggle. Number 2, pick a regular bedtime and stick to it as much as you can. Remember, kids thrive with routines and predictability, and so do adults for that matter, right? And once you pick a time, plan ahead so that you can start getting your little ones ready for bed about an hour ahead of time, because it takes a while. So if you want them asleep by 8:30, it'd be a good idea to get started about 7:30, right? Whatever time you choose, let your child know what the routine is, including time limits, and help them stick to it with some guidance and gentle reminders. You might say, hey, it's almost 8:30. I'll give you 5 more minutes and then it's time to get your bath going. Or something like, you can play with your toys for another 3 minutes, but then it's time to get jammies on and brush your teeth and get into bed. Okay, buddy? You could even give them choices. Kids love choices, such as, do you want to brush your teeth first or take a bath first? And you could do the same with which toys they want to choose to have in the bathtub that night and so on. And as you stick to a specific bedtime routine, including a specific time, their bodies and brains will start to sync with the pattern, and their rhythms will be more natural, so it won't be as hard for them to settle down. And a little bonus tip here. The synchrony will happen even better if you limit their screen time usage before bed. That can help their brains recognize it's time to start to wind down. Okay, tip number 3 is to make nighttime a special time for you and your child. Have specific things that you do every night that help you bond, help them feel secure, and signal to them that it's time for bed. For example, you might give them a bath, have them brush their teeth and get their pajamas on, read a book together, or talk about their day. They might also love it if you sing them a song and snuggle. And for some kiddos, a special blanket or stuffed animal can also help them settle down. Try to keep going to bed positive. If you send your kiddos to bed as a punishment, it will only make them dislike going to bed. This leads to frustration and tantrums. Not what we're going for, right? Instead, try to remember that helping your little one get ready for bed can make them feel important and loved and end the day on a good note for both of you. So there you have it. 3 things that can help with your kiddos' sleep patterns. And not only can these tips help kiddos get enough sleep, they can help bedtime become a way for you to connect, which is what we all need. I'd love to know what works for you when it comes to bedtime rituals. Be sure to leave a comment, give it a like, share it with others, and subscribe so you don't miss my other videos. And that's all for now. I'm Dr. Dave, and this has been another video on parenting tips for kids 2 through 6.
For the best relationship tips and happy hacks, visit drdavespeaks.com.